My name is Saladino Marini and I'm a journalist. Actually, I'm stationed in Zagreb, but by accident I'm here today. In this part of the world, there is a very intensive debate about the reform of the EU treaty, and Croatia is just in time for this. So I'd like to know your opinion. What do you think about the reform of the treaties, and especially in that context of redefinition of the free movement of people, workers, etc., and probably of a very integrated Eurozone? Thank you.
As I said, it's a permanent campaign. So it never settles down. Time and again, you know, the story and the rumors spring up that we're just about to re-reform again. So never in the history of the European Union there was a silent time when we really had an opportunity to focus and work. You finish one process and then the new one starts. I'm not much in favor of any fundamental or in principle any changes to the existing framework, because that's something that we have agreed to. We just concluded our talks. And I think that we have just enough Europe. Maybe some corrections should be made. Maybe. Well, for instance, unlike the UK, Croatia has that kind of all but obligation to join the Eurozone. If you ask me today whether it would be fully beneficial for my country, the answer is pending. I don't know yet. But I know. And I think that I always knew that, even 15 years ago when we discussed this as young or less young diplomats, that when you create monetary union, some kind of fiscal discipline or fiscal grip must exist, and Europe had none. And it eventually it costed dearly countries like Greece, Italy, and the others for that lack of discipline. So the same story reiterates here in the UK with Scotland and England. Provided that Scotland leaves one day, you're going to have a monetary union. Who's going to control that? Who's going to control politicians in Scotland and the other way around? So that's something that might be mitigated in a way. But I'm not in favor of further surrendering, no matter how medieval this might sound, national prerogatives to the Brussels. I'm prime minister now, I will not be tomorrow, figuratively, but the countries as fundamental political entities remain. So, we have enough Europe, and it's great, but it's enough.